Every time you and I breathe, one half of the oxygen that we consume has been produced by microscopic plants in the ocean. So regardless of where you are on the land, the ocean does matter to you.
The ocean makes up more than 70% of the Earth, and yet we have only 10, 12% of it actually mapped. That's our own planet. Mars is completely mapped. The moon is completely mapped. That's unacceptable. The public should not stand for that.
Maps are what guide us through everything we do. And we have three quarters of our planet that is virtually unmapped. And people say, well, you know, what are you going to find there? Well, we don't know. And you don't know until you map it.
So often do we just stand at the shore of the ocean and look beyond it and naively think we know everything about it under that surface. And that's a surface we haven't even scratched. We've got to map the world's oceans.
It is my great privilege, on behalf of the IHO, IOC, GEMCO Guiding Committee, and the Nippon Foundation, to welcome you to Monaco and to this forum on the future of ocean floor mapping.
GEMCO is recognized as the only international project with a mandate to map the floor of our global oceans. The forum will determine new goals for the future mapping of the world's oceans over the next decade. We cannot achieve sustainable goals unless we know more about the oceans. And without doubt, we have so much more to learn.
This forum's big role is really trying to get the word out there that the planet as a whole is important and the oceans are as important as everything else.
Whether it's for food, whether it's for energy, whether it's to understand why the climate is changing. And we're doing all that with no map. This is crazy.
The average person who's not a mariner doesn't realize how much their lives are daily impacted by that which is taking place out on the ocean, or that which is taking place under the ocean, or things that come up from the ocean.
Mapping does matter, especially in the context of the deep sea, where we are indeed entering a brave new world of ocean exploration, exploitation, and ocean conservation.
What's happening here is bringing the community together. And the community is really a lot of different groups. It is industry as us, which support this vision with technology. It's all the user groups, it's all the different nations, and then it's organizing all these groups.
There's some companies which want to be part of the next generation of data. They want to give something back to the community, and that's quite important for the commercial sector.
It's like having a big puzzle, and each person, each country, each institutions can contribute with a piece of this whole puzzle.
This is a massive effort. It's actually a lot of work, and we are just few people. So GEMCO is just planting seeds.
Capacity development is an essential tenet of IOC's mission. It enables all member states to participate in and benefit from ocean research and services that are vital to sustainable development and human welfare on the planet.
The number of major maritime nations is increasing. The number of helping hands to take this project on is increasing. So here we meet at the International Hydrographic Organization and the Intergovernmental Oceanographic Commission and GEMCO. We have those organizations committed to open data sharing, so that which one nation may acquire will be shared with all the other nations.
One of the most exciting things about the future of ocean mapping is the enthusiasm about collaborating. It seems like for so many years, for so long, it's all been about what can my country do? What can we go and map and then hold on to? And now, more and more, we're working together and we realize that we can't do it alone.
It's going to be achieved by a combination of countries working together at a regional and then a global scale. There's a huge part for the private sector to play, and there's a huge part for society at large to play.
We want to make sure that the public at large understands how amazing a planet we live on.
The biggest obstacle to mapping the ocean is fiscal will. Using current technology, it'll cost about $3 billion to map the world ocean. And the $3 billion is for the deep water, but that does represent 94% of the ocean. That sounds like a lot of money. But we do that many times over every time we fly a mission to Mars. It costs about $3 billion. And we have maps of Mars that are far better than the maps of this planet. So we're willing to do that for Mars, and I think that's wonderful. I take nothing away from that. But why are we not willing to spend that on our own planet?
I am convinced that if we are to strive towards sustainable development, improving bathymetric map is critical.
With bathymetry and knowledge of the resources of the seafloor, I believe we can help overcome poverty. We as individuals in this room, I believe we can help combat climate change, all of us in this room. I believe we can all make an incredible impact to the future of this planet.
I tell children that their generation is going to explore more of Earth than all previous generations combined. As soon as we finish that map, the explorers are right behind it.
The ocean is still the space of few scientists. We need to have people thinking that this is their space and keep it for us and for our future generations.
We now have the enthusiasm, the technology, and the vision to actually truly make a difference.